Pokercast is sponsored by CollectorsCash.com, who now have your new set Next Destinies in stock at amazing prices. Get your boxes, sealed products, and single cards like Mewtwo EX for the most competitive prices around, as well as all of your current format goodies within easy reach. If you're looking to stock up on anything Pokemon or any other card game for that matter, then head over to CollectorsCash.com after the show. Hey everybody, and welcome to episode 60 of Pokercast. Sorry the video updates have been very slow recently, but today I've been able to prepare a ton of videos to be uploaded over the course of the week, including the start of my new Let's Play, recorded PTCGO games, and of course these Pokercast episodes. So where do we currently stand at the moment? Well, cities are pretty much over for everybody now, and a new set has just hit our competitive scene, which every player has been testing frantically since its release. However, the big question is, how does this set affect our current metagame? And the answer isn't quite straightforward. The new set brings a lot to the table, and we have a major tournament coming up called the ECC, which is going to put our new format right into perspective. So this episode is going to be all about it. Let's get straight to it. So the ECC stands for the European Challenge Cup, and it's held every year in the European country of the Netherlands, and it's usually the first major tournament that gives us an idea of how the newest set will fare in the competitive world at the time. Last year, the set was Call of Legends, and Lost Skull was expected to be an incredible force there, possibly breaking the game as most players thought. However, even though a variation of Lost Skull did come second, it didn't quite make the splash everyone thought it would, and that shaped the rest of the world's metagame accordingly, namely spreading the word to include certain techs. Could we be seeing something similar this year with all the hype we're seeing at the moment? I definitely think that we could be, as this tournament is much more important than just being the biggest tournament in Europe, but a look ahead at the future metagame for the entire world. Whatever does well at this tournament will be played and tested by more players everywhere, because they will have proof that deck tests well and performs well in a competitive environment, which players such as the Americans haven't been able to test competitively yet. We know what has hype, but there's a big difference between hype and those cards being put in competitive practice. So let's have a look at what's being hyped, what isn't, and what you should be looking out for when you're either competing in the ECC or the events after it. First up, let's start with the big guns, EXs, and the biggest gun of them all, Mewtwo EX. This guy has a ridiculous amount of hype, but this time, the hype isn't being put in the wrong place, as was the case with Gengar Prime. This card will be played, and played in high numbers, simply because it's a card that can be centered around its own deck, or be splashed into pretty much anything else to deal ridiculous amounts of damage on your opponent's unsuspecting Pokémon. X-Ball is good against pretty much everything, and with a huge 170 HP, not much is going to KO it in one shot, bar Magnezone. With the extremely powerful EXs hitting the scene needing 4 energy to attack, you're going to need to be wary of Mewtwo in pretty much every game you play, not only when you play down your own attack with 4 or more energy on it, but when you play your own Mewtwo on your opponent. Now, I don't think Mewtwo will be a threat in its own deck, but there is always Mewtwo Celebi, a deck which hasn't been at the top of everyone's list, but has been mumbled about in the community. This is just a quick list I've drawn up, and please bear in mind that this isn't tested at all. Basically, this runs the same amount as a simple Duran, but has a completely different goal in mind. The aim of the deck is simple, throw as many energy onto your Mewtwo as possible and start taking prizes from turn 2 through the use of Celebi's Poké Power, which allows you to attach an extra grass energy per turn as long as Celebi is active. With the new Sky Arrow Bridge there to give your support Pokémon free retreat, there isn't much there to stop you from taking speedy prizes and hitting for massive amounts of damage. Now, I won't turn this into a deck video, but this was just to give you an idea of how the deck works to maybe try it out for yourself. Give it a go if you're still struggling for a play at the moment. Now for the rest of the expected decks, I'm going to base off of our latest tournament here in the UK, since it was a city's event with Next Destinies being legal, and the results were quite interesting. I know that one tournament is no way enough to base potential ECC decks off of, but at least gives us ground to murk off of to looking at what to expect. So the top 4 of the tournament look like this. Magnezone Electric, ZPST with Mewtwo, Regigigas and Zekrom EX, Duran and Mewtwo Celebi. In the end, there was a top 2 of Duran against ZPST, with the ZPST player coming out on top in a very close best of 3. What you should find interesting is that NEC Destinies is involved in half of the top four, and Wombi in the deck mentioned just a few moments ago. Magnezone Electric is still going strong, and I would base that off of the fact that 4 energy for a KO on an EX for 2 prizes is actually a really nice trade, making Magnezone a remaining contender in the new format right now. The ZPST, to me, is one of the most interesting since it splashed in 3 different EXs, which are all compatible with Zekrom's energy acceleration to keep bringing huge attackers to the field from as soon as turn 1. And of course, there's everyone's favourite deck, Duran, still hitting high in the tables at competitive tournaments, and I believe the deck has actually gotten a bit stronger because of a couple of cards brought to us from NEC Destinies. With the new EX Pokemon being all the rage, and having attacks that cost 4 or more energy, both Lost Remover and Crushing Hammer have become more lethal when used at the right times, limiting your opponent's options more than ever, and Duran actually walls Mewtwo quite nicely if you get to slow them down enough, when you factor in the low energy requirement of Devour and the psychic resistance Duran carries. The release of Level Ball means that you have guaranteed search for single Duran in the form of a trainer, rather than having to rely on dual ball flips, and the new stadiums can become interesting additions too. Duran is going from strength to strength at the moment, and we could see some hitting the top tables with some nifty new tricks up their sleeves. Speaking of Zekrom from earlier, we could see a rise in the use of Strake Zekrom Electric decks over Magnezone Electric decks, including Zekrom, because we now have the very powerful Zekrom EX to inflict massive damage onto the opponent. From the very early turns, you could have yourself hitting a Bolt Strike on your opponent, leaving them in a tough position, but now you have the addition of Zekrom EX. You could also be going for a massive 150 attack to follow up with on the later stages of the game. Pair its 180 HP with Eviolite and you have yourself a massive attacker, further capable of being able to abuse double colourless energy. I won't be too sure whether this version of the deck is better than the one with Magnezone, but I would say it has a significant boost with the next set. But of course, Magnezone is still staying strong since they also benefit from both Mewtwo and Zekrom EX to add to their attacking arsenal. Whether it's Magnezone, Zekrom or Mewtwo you're using to attack, each one is going to be one-shotting your opponent's EXs, or taking regular prizes off of their supporting Pokemon, something every other deck in the format struggles to do well. Magnezone keeps your consistency with its Pokepower, as we all know, and can also stay up front as an attacker, taking a game-changing 2 prizes off of any EX your opponent lays on the field. This deck was strong before the new set hit the scene, but it gets even stronger since it can utilise the strongest cards we receive in the set. If you weren't wary of this deck before, then definitely brace for this one, since it could be springing up all sorts of surprises on you with its rapid energy acceleration. Let's move on to the veterans of the format now, since both ZPST and Reshiram Typhlosion are still going to be good contenders in this new format. As seen earlier, Zekrom gains pretty much every splashable EX, since it has an extremely fast form of energy acceleration to abuse, and Reshiram Typhlosion gains Reshiram EX too as another target for Afterburner. To be honest, there isn't a lot of change with these decks apart from squeezing in those powerful new EXs, but it does show that decks with built-in energy acceleration will take to these new cards very nicely, since they can take opponents by surprise, setting up a very powerful counter-attack in just a single turn. I think that this very point is going to add a lot more skill to the format, something we all wanted to see. One more deck I want to touch up on is Six Corners, a deck I've become quite a fan of lately, and the main reason is because of this card, Prism Energy. As mentioned in my NEC Destinies set review, this card gives a Six Corners player the option of having 8 energy in their deck that counters any energy they like on all of their Pokemon. Not too shabby at all. The only thing I think that's keeping this deck from being amazing in this format is now its damage output. Virizion could still do work on Pokemon such as Tynamo and the odd Cyndaquil, but the damage output just isn't there to take up huge EXs, unless you utilise your own. The obvious choice of Mewtwo EX is going to counter your opponent's use of it, but I would probably suggest 2 since you want to stay ahead of the Mewtwo race. Zekrom EX is also an option, along with both Regigigas and Kyurem EX to cover types and take advantage of both Eviolite and Colour's energy cost, where Regigigas is concerned. Regigigas could creep its way in because of the mentioned colourless cost, and because it's pretty much impossible to KO in one hit with Eviolite attached, when not using Magnezone, and can hit back hard when taking heavy damage. I guess I could also mention Shaymin EX, one of my personal favourites, and simply because it can be your late game attacker to finish off earlier damaged EXs, or even a fresh one depending on your opponent's prize count. I think this card is very underrated at the moment, and should be tested out in builds that can utilise it in one turn. Other than that, Six Corners are going to need some tweaks, but I think we could see some play of this huge HP based deck. So in conclusion, our format hasn't changed completely, but guessing what is in your opponent's deck is becoming more of a challenge, simply because our card pool of good competitive cards is getting much bigger and deck builds are becoming more refined, making for an extremely interesting tournament up ahead. We have our old favourites such as Reshiram Typhlosion still hitting hard with the inclusion of Reshiram EX, and new decks still being born with cards such as Celebrity Prime becoming playable. The format and the game at the moment is evolving in a very nice way indeed, and I hope that this episode brought you at least some insight into what to expect with the slight shift we should be seeing upon the release of next Destinies. Thank you for watching this episode of Poker Class. Make sure you rate, comment and subscribe as usual, and stay tuned for some brand new videos coming your way in the next few days. Oh, and good luck to all of you attending the ECC next weekend. I'm looking forward to some very interesting results.